All right, welcome to Talking Investing. I am Tom, and as always, this is not financial advice. Today, I want to do a video on CORZ Scientific, stock ticker CORZ. They put out a massive press release today, major change in their business. So we've been talking about this on this channel for a while, so I want to bring everybody up to speed on exactly what this means for CORZ Scientific. So if you're new to the channel, we follow Bitcoin to Bitcoin miners all the time. So remember to subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell. Also, if everybody could please smash the like button, it helps the channel out a lot. Lastly, if you want to join the channel and become a member, there's some extra content. We do a members only live stream, and the members get to pick a company once a week for me to do a deep dive video on. So we'd love to have you join as a member. It's only $5. Okay, so let's talk about CORZ Scientific. They put a press release out this morning. CORZ Scientific has now officially filed for bankruptcy. So I want to go through what that means, because there's a lot of different ways to file for bankruptcy, and it means a lot of different things depending on what your balance sheet looks like. So I want to try and go through specifically and see what does this mean for CORZ Scientific shareholders, because that's who we are. We're the investors. We're the shareholders. So I want to go from that perspective and try and look at what does this mean for the price of their stock? Is there anything left at all here? Is there a chance that this stock could rebound? Okay, so first of all, let's take a look at what it's doing today. Right now, and it's the middle of the trading day, so I don't know where this is going to end, but at the moment, CORZ is down about 43.5% on the day. They're trading at 11.76 cents. That's just a few hundredths of a cent within their all-time low, which they hit, you know, just a few days ago. Then they had a big, giant run-up. So unfortunately, a lot of people may have gotten caught in this gigantic run-up. Hopefully, you made money on that run-up and got out, but if you bought high, unfortunately, the stock has since crashed since then. Several days ago, B. Riley, which is one of their major creditors, put out a plan to try and keep CORZ Scientific out of bankruptcy. So I did a separate video on that. You can check it out, and I went through what that plan meant. To me, that felt like a long shot. It did not make a lot of sense to me, but they did put the plan out, and the stock absolutely skyrocketed. At one point, it was up close to 300% in a 1 or 2 day period off of this news, but the euphoria quickly settled when I think people realized that this plan was not necessarily going to happen, and the plan that they proposed wasn't necessarily going to solve their problem. So that was just less than a week ago. So here we are less than 1 week later, and now CORZ Scientific has in fact filed for Chapter 11 bankruptcy. So I want to go through the press release first, and let's take a look at what they have to say. Okay, CORZ Scientific announces comprehensive restructuring transaction. So this is what their press release is calling it, but here on the first line you will see in bold print, voluntarily files for reorganization under Chapter 11. Chapter 11 is a bankruptcy. So they have filed for a reorganization through the bankruptcy process, which means they want to stay in business. They want a business to come out of the other end of this process. But as it stands right now, they can't pay their bills. They can't pay their creditors. And if they just keep doing what they're doing, they're going to run out of cash imminently and go out of business. So there is this vehicle to restructure, and it's called Chapter 11. The thing is, what does this mean for shareholders? Because for CORZ Scientific, for the company, for their employees, for their management, this probably means this company is going to survive and move forward. In fact, this gives them a little window of total relief where they can continue to operate business as usual. And if you look at their website, although they did not put out a Bitcoin mining update for the month of November, and that is the first month in 2022 they did not put one of those out, they did show their daily Bitcoin mining every day. So I do think that they broke their all-time record. They must have mined somewhere north of 1,200, maybe even 1,300 or 1,400 Bitcoin in the month of November. Either way, they're still up and running, and they're likely to duplicate those results in December and then again in January going forward. So operationally, these guys are still the biggest Bitcoin miner. The problem is there going to be anything left for shareholders at all? So the fact that management and the company gets to move on does not really help a shareholder if there's no money left for shareholders and essentially the price of this stock goes to zero. So I'm not saying that that's what's going to happen. Obviously, this is not financial advice, but I want to walk you through the process and show you that I do think shareholders are in big trouble. Shareholders, just by the nature of a Chapter 11, are paid last. And this company has racked up almost $1 billion in debt. That's one of the things we've been talking about on this channel, and I have made a list of companies that I thought were at the highest risk of filing for bankruptcy. This was number one on my list. I'm just gonna go to that list for 1 second. CORZ Scientific was number one on my list. So they are now, in fact, the first ones that are going into Chapter 11. Number two on my list, GRE, I did a video on the other day. They are doing a major reorganization outside of Chapter 11. I don't think that's gonna be enough, so in my opinion, they're also going to have to file for Chapter 11 bankruptcy, but we will wait and see. Again, I don't know the future. This is not financial advice, so please do your own due diligence on all of these. But you can see these are super ultra high risk stocks. The company remains significantly cash flow positive on a debt-free basis. So essentially what that means is they're generating plenty of cash from operations. The problem is they have almost $1 billion in debt, so they have to pay interest on that debt and they have to pay principal on portions of that debt. Those were the things that were drying up their liquidity. They did not have anywhere near enough money to pay the interest and principal on the debt that was coming due over the course of the next 1 month, never mind the next 12 months. Now, obviously, you take all that debt away, you take the $1 billion away, you take the interest away, and this company does have a gross profit and it generates money. So the company is committed to operating normally during the implementation of the restructuring. The company remains dedicated to providing hosting services and self-mining in its state-of-the-art data center. Okay, I'm gonna skip ahead because here, to me, this is the really important sentence. Pursuant to the contemplated restructuring support agreement, the company's existing convertible note holders will equitize their debt into a significant majority of the common stock of the reorganized company. So a significant majority. That, while that language is somewhat vague, I think it paints a fairly clear picture. The significant majority means that they are going to be diluting their stock massively. This could be 70, 80, 90, 95% dilution by the time they get through with this reorganization. So, you know, obviously we'll have to wait and see for the details, but. So then they say, in addition, holders of the general unsecured claims and existing common shareholders would also receive meaningful recoveries. So I don't know what kind of meaningful recoveries are gonna be left after you've given a significant majority of the common stock to the debt holders. They are trying to indicate here that there will be something left over, and obviously something is better than nothing. So there's no real way to predict what comes out the other side of this, but I'm gonna look at the balance sheet for a minute just to show you the hole they have to dig themselves out of. So even at 11 cents, for me, this is something I'm staying far away from. So again, not financial advice. You guys may feel like that this is a gigantic discount, and you know, if they're successful in their reorganization, there are a lot of upsides to this company. So you've got to do your own due diligence and make those decisions on your own. Okay, so first things first, here's their balance sheet. So you can see their total current liabilities are $1.289 billion. Their total current assets are $213 million. So that leaves them $1 billion short of being able to pay their current liabilities. All right, let's just take a quick look at the chart. So you can see CORZ Scientific gave a heads up quite a while ago that they were not going to be making payments on their debt. So at that point, you can see a gigantic drop off. This is a 1 day huge gap from somewhere in the 80 cent range to somewhere down in the 25 cent range. So that's where the majority of their stock fell. They then went sideways up and down a little bit. You can see two gigantic green days here. Those don't look like much, but you'll see that's about a 300% increase in these couple of days, and that was just about a week ago. So that was on B. Riley announcing a plan and making an offer to say, here, we can get you guys through without you going through bankruptcy, and shareholders got excited about that, but unfortunately, that did not come to fruition. And so now here we are back down just a couple of hundredths of a penny off of their all-time low. Actually, now, as we're speaking, as I'm making this video, they have now hit their all-time low. So the previous all-time low was 11.38 cents, and they're now at 11.02 cents. So this is now their all-time low, and they could go down from here. They could recover a little from here as news comes in. So to me, this becomes more of a day trading stock. So for you, I guess if you believe that at the end of this process, they're gonna come out of the other side of this, there will be something left for shareholders, and it's probably a long-term play, but who knows, maybe in 2, 3, 4, 5 years, if they get where they're going, even the small tiny piece that's left for shareholders may be worth a meaningful amount of money. So I don't have the answer to that. Again, please be very careful investing in this company and all the Bitcoin miners, because you can see they are going through a very, very difficult time. Okay, so that's the latest and greatest on CORZ Scientific. Thanks so much for watching. Remember to subscribe to the channel and smash the like button, and I will see you in the next video.